Thank you. Ah, a wandering pirate. Ye be lost? Where be your ship? Ah, sank, did she? Well, as all good ships do. You know, that reminds me of a tale. Of an elusive ship that sailed the seas, plundering and pillaging for gold and glory. Out of every treasure they'd ever dared to seek out, there was only one that could truly satisfy the captain's greed, the crow's eye. An unfortunate rival also sought out the eye. Listen if you dare, little ones, for the sea has a story to tell. The tale ye shall hear starts long ago, where the first face-off for the eye takes place. A devastating battle ends both sides short, leaving the treasury lost for what seemingly would be forever.
Thank you.
When the two never returned, many gave up on the treasure. Fewer and fewer looked until it was nothing more than a myth to all. All but two. While the pirate captain had a lead, another wasn't far behind. A captain on the opposing side was making this search a race, one that neither side was willing to lose. Two raced separately until the day came when they had to face each other, in none other than the legendary Pirate's Cove, the final race for the Eye. And where is the glorious crew now? The sea holds many tales, old and new. Our tale may be over, but there are always more to seek out. There will always be stories to tell, gold to plunder, and unruly beasts to seek out. May we meet again, perhaps over a grog or two.
Yeah. Mr. Cleric would like to cordially invite you all to a ravishing evening full of fun and glamour. This black tie event will require your best gowns, tailcoats, and family diamonds. If you don't don your mask at this time and embrace that feeling of mystery as we dive into our show, A Musical Masquerade. Our first guest, the most handsomely wealthy woman on this side of the Atlantic, Vivian
Rose, my best business partner, runs a beautifully profitable oil rigging company that has swept the nation like wildfire. Wouldn't trade her for the world. And then there's Miss Lorelei Livington, who runs an illustrious diamond mining company. Of course, she's coming all her bling tonight.
Recently getting his hands on a massive inheritance, big enough
to make it worth keeping him around, Edward Gray.
And of course, our host of this fabulous party, Sebastian Cleric.
Thank you all so much for coming. It means the world to me.
For after the party. Is there anyone you're trying to get at?
Oh, friend, I've got plans. Tonight's the prime time to practically steal the company up from my guests' feet. I intend to make the most out of tonight.
I hear ya. Hey, can we get some drinks over here? I'm parched.
Oh, please. You're being such a flirt. No wonder your father couldn't stand you.
I seem to have my fair share of charm with the ladies, though, no. My mom clearly liked you well enough. Thanks to her, I get to be here and meet you.
Oh, please. You're being too much. If I hadn't known any better, I'd think you altered the will and killed her yourself.
No! She's dead!
She was poisoned.
Poisoned? Like not alive anymore. Oh my God! Wait.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay. It's okay. You're okay. Come here. I'll help you. I'll keep you safe. Don't worry, Lorelai. I'll protect you.
Protect me? Protect me? I can protect myself. Do you have to treat me like I'm a princess stuck in a tower? I built my company from the ground up. I'm not some damsel.
It's not like you're gonna be able to live without me anyway. And now that I've bought your little company out from under your feet.
You what?
What are you gonna do without me, huh? Start begging on the streets? You would be better suited as my wife.
You are just horrible!
Feign your ignorance.
What? Who? Lorelai? She's dead?
Of course you'd say that, you pig.
I swear I would have no reason to hurt her. But the host would. You guys share the body and kill her.
Yeah, you're right. Same with Vivian's company, too. Spiking her drink earlier when she got it would have been so easy. Did you really think you could get away with it? Get him! Lock him up! Take him away! This is ridiculous. In my own home, at my own party, these people.
You know, Master, you can be quite dramatic at times.
What are you talking about?
Well, first, you stroll this extravagant party with no regard for the number of people you've invited. It really has been straining the help.
And? I don't see why you should have an opinion on that. You are here to do your job, and that is all. You should be grateful I allowed you to eat off the same china as us.
That's not a very nice thing to say in a position such as your own. Say, Master, do you even know the name of any of the help? Even me?
No. I never thought it a priority to get to know you people.
Oh, you people? Quite interesting. I suppose it makes sense, given you treat us as if we are animals, spitting on us, calling us vile names, brushing us off. You must think you're grateful even acknowledging our existence. Your whole family is evil, manipulative people, the whole lot of you. My mother, father, and sister are treated like dirt because of you. I killed your snake-like little friends. I've destroyed your reputation. I could take so much more from you. But you know what? I think it's time I end it here. There's one last thing and I can take from you. And that's your life.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for supporting us at our 2023 Beats and Treats concert. We hope you enjoyed the show. This concert has been a student-led, teacher-facilitated concert. Each show concept for each ensemble was designed by the students and was really fun to work with. Each ensemble putting together a pretty fantastic show. Can we please give another round of applause for our level one, level two, and level three ensembles? Each year, we have a few awards and recognitions to share with our families. So here we go. First off, the band department awards lettering points for music activities which go above and beyond the normal requirements for class. This includes additional ensembles like marching band, pep band, pit orchestra, jazz band, solo and ensemble contest, other performances, community groups, and other service to the program. And I'm sure I'm forgetting a few. Oh, United Sound. There's always more. They represent opportunities for our students to continue developing their musical skills outside of the classroom, and lettering in band is meant to honor all of that extra work that students do beyond the classroom expectations. On the screens above me, you'll see scrolling through names of all of the band students from all three ensembles who have lettered this year. So band students, if you lettered this year, can you please stand up so we can celebrate you? Congratulations. Thank you. I want to give a special shout out to two students who, it's a point-based system, I'm not going to bore you with the details, but it's really difficult for a freshman in their first year band to letter, and you might have caught at the beginning, we have two students, Natalie and Haley, that lettered in their freshman year in band, so congratulations, you two. Next, I would like to recognize a phenomenal young musician in our program. Coon Rapids has been on somewhat of a streak lately with students auditioning into the Minnesota Allstate Band. It takes a high level of musicianship and dedication to earn placement into that ensemble through a challenging audition process. For this coming 23-24 Allstate Band, please give an enormous congratulations to our bass clarinetist, Madeline Metzler. Can you stand up? Ray and Tennyson, that's two bass clarinets in a row. So next, okay. Let's keep it going. The next award that I'll give out is the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award. I would first like to recognize all of the students who participated in either Jazz 1 and or Jazz 2 this year. Can those students please stand up to be celebrated? Thank you for your extra commitment that you have shown in these after-school activities. The Louis Armstrong Jazz Award is given to a student in recognition of their outstanding achievements in the field of jazz, as demonstrated through superior musicianship, character, and individual creativity. This student's work in researching and selecting music was an invaluable service. His fascination with jazz music, and really music of all genres, is inspiring. His consistent high level of musicianship in jazz and elsewhere has been an asset to every ensemble he has participated in. Please congratulate our 2023 Louis Armstrong Jazz Award recipient, Eli Head. Next up, we have the Orion Award. The Orion Award was established in 1948 to give national recognition to senior class band members class members chosen by their schools for outstanding achievement in band, orchestra, or choir. We're in band. Students who receive Orion Awards attain both high academic and community standing. Students in our bands were asked to choose the person that they thought most exemplifies the following: positive individual contribution to the band program, high scholastic standing, positive influence on the culture of the band classroom, and exceptional personal and professional performing ability and musicianship. So, selected by our students, please congratulate the 2023 Orion Award recipient, Jesse Coe. And the final award is the John Philip Sousa Award. This is given to an upperclassman who has devoted many years of his life to the band program. It has been an incredible experience for me to watch this person change, develop, and grow over the past 4 years. She has devoted countless hours to practicing not only her primary instrument, but all of the other instruments she has played in pep band, marching band, jazz bands, and yes, even the Minnesota All-State Band. It is clear she is motivated to leave her own legacy behind here at Coon Rapids Band Program. She has succeeded in doing that. It would take me an hour or so, and there's time waiting, to list out everything she has done above and beyond expectations of a band student. I do not know where she has found the time to do all of these extra things that she does, but she needs to know that I, the program, and countless band students that come after her. I shouldn't have. Well, Ben, congratulations to the John Phillips Sousa Award winner, Maria Carson. Savannah, it was supposed to be you, not me. Help a little bit? Yeah. But here it comes. This is for the senior class. So, seniors, y'all back there, you should come on stage, okay?
Can we help get some chairs ready for them?
We'll take a moment here. I'm going to skip around a little bit in my program. We got to get these. Yes, so afterwards, please join us in the cafeteria for some free pie, cookies, coffee, lemonade, and entertainment from Jazz One. Come and enjoy, hang out for a little while, celebrate all our hard work this year, and then head out. I don't have another speech for you down there. No, sorry. This is fine. Okay, seniors. This is the group where we together have come full circle. You started your high school career like every other class that came before you. We marched together, jazzed together, got peppy together, made music together, all of the things. For a long time, those opportunities were taken away from us. In spite of it all, we tried to connect to each other. Digital concerts, thank you, Manla. No cheers for that, okay, all right. I figured. All right, pause for applause, scratch it out, all right. We played 10 feet away from each other, up and down these aisles and up on the balconies with bell covers and puppy pads and all that fun stuff. The puppy pads were for their spit dogs. I do let them have bathroom breaks. Not marching band. We even cobbled together a makeshift marching band season. So happy to be here. It was something. Each year in this speech, I say some form of thank you for your leadership, for your service, for your years, all those kinds of things. But I need you, you in particular, to understand how different that statement is this year. You all know as well as I that things change during our time. A band program of 180 students was suddenly 110. Your leadership meant more than any other class before. Because you had the resilience to stick with it, this program is growing back, stronger than ever. That is because of you, each and every one of you. It doesn't matter if you're the kid that showed up every day to play in class, if you were the one that took your instrument home every night to practice, or the one who signed up for everything whenever I said, fill out this form if you wish to do this thing, and then you put your name on it. Each and every one of you has brought to our table the best thing, yourself. You have all demonstrated resilience, commitment, and perseverance that anyone can and should be proud of. Now I want each of you, all of the band students, to take a moment to reflect on what you have given to this program, whether it's your first year or your last year. Your time, your energy, your musical skills, yourself. Now ask yourself, why? Why did you do that? Why are you doing that? Why have you chosen to give? And please get past the easy answers. My friends are here. My parents made me. I love practicing so much, I just need to find more ways to put my instrument in the day. It applies to at least one of them. Why have so many of you given so much? I hope that it's at least partly because you have gotten something out of this experience. Friends, joy, comfort, safety, a way to express yourself. What we do here, nights like these and every single day in our classroom, is to give and to get. Everything you give is to somebody in this room, and everything you have got is from somebody in this room. Seniors, what you have helped to rebuild here at Coon Rapids Band Program. It's a beautiful and lasting thing. I'm from the bottom.
Stop.
From the bottom of our thank you. Because we wouldn't be here tonight and we would show up this without you.
Well, thank you.
As you prepare to leave Coon Rapids High School, I have just one last request for you. Please find a way to keep music in your life. Each and every one of you has spent years building a gift worth sharing with the world, so please go forth and share it. Seniors, for everything you've done and everything you've become, thank you.